Hello friends, now I am going to dictate. Start in 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, start. I write to seek clarification on the press note issued by the Ministry of Industrial Development on 1st January 1972, permitting 54 important industries to increase production with a view to utilize their existing plant and machinery to the maximum extent possible. While this press note is certainly welcome and will prove to be valuable for increasing industrial production, I think it raises certain doubts regarding industries which are not covered by the list. The point I have in mind is whether those industries which have not found their place in the list would be permitted to operate on a multi-shift basis. I raise this point because the press note seems to imply that where no specific sanction has been made, capacity licensed on a single shift basis should be considered as total licensed capacity. In other words, there seems to be no distinction in government's current thinking between a license granted on a single shift basis, as was the wont in most cases for many years following introduction of IDR Act, and one where total capacity figures are given on a maximum utilization basis. If this is correct, it will mean that the present thinking of government in a sense may mean a reversal of government's intention to allow production on a multi-shift basis. If this is not in the case, there seems to be no point in allotting capacities on a single shift basis. Most COB licenses were granted on a single shift basis, and the practice of issuing license on a maximum utilization basis was of much later origin. In fact, industrial units which exist prior to the introduction of DR Act 1951 got themselves registered and were licensed for certain quantities on a single shift basis, which was not the same thing as their existing capacity. According to some of our members, although they were not formally informed in writing that multi-shift working would be allowed without further reference to government, mainly because the question did not arise at that stage. In discussion with the senior official of the Ministry of Industrial Development and DGTD, they have over the years informed that this would be the position. In a particular case, I have seen the correspondence exchanged with government, and the member has been advised by the government as early as. I am, however, to add that license under Industries Development and Regulation Act is not required to work your existing industrial undertaking on a multi-shift basis. Again, in 1966, when the member had an actual production of 90 million rupees closure at Bombay and requested that the single shift assessed capacity of 12 million per annum be increased to regularize the large production brought about by increase in productivity to 75 million closures per annum. On single shift basis, government had white letter dated 27 May 1966 raised their capacity to 24 million per annum and stated that you may produce more by working extra shifts. In short, additional production was being regularized by giving a slightly increased single shift capacity on the understanding that multiple shift working would be allowed.